All right, fellow nerds, there's been a lot made about how MeWe is different than Facebook or Twitter, and some people aren't comfortable with it. I get that. So I'd like to kind of run you through how MeWe is different and how you make it work for you, being how it's not babysat by AIs that want to enforce community standards that shouldn't exist. So, on MeWe, basically, since you're an adult, if someone says something you don't like or you don't particularly care for what they're doing, block them. That's it. You don't get to report them. You don't get to trash them. You don't get to shut down their voice, just like they don't get to shut down your voice. So just block them. So, anyways, when you open MeWe, you start on the home page. Now, here's the kind of the cool thing. It's a combined messenger group chat kind of arrangement. And also it's got a number of feeds. So when you open up on the main feed here, if you see this feed as you drop down quickly, what this basically is all of your friends, your contacts, recent posts by them. And you can actually set it up for recent posts or popular posts. Unlike Facebook, it truly is recent posts, not recycled posts. So you can drag down through these. Again, these are individuals. Now, if you've joined a number of groups and you want to see what's going on in the groups, you click the pages, oh, sorry, the groups rather, groups. Now, the posts from groups recently in the groups, and it doesn't matter whether there were five posts or just one post, the recent group posts will show up, and the posts that you're a member of, like I'm a member of Monster Hunter Nation and also Fantasy Art, will start popping up here. So you can go into that group then and look around. So unlike the Facebook feed where it does groups and pages and individuals all in the same feed, this allows you to change it to groups or your homepage, which is individuals, or pages, which is a page you may be following. Pages is kind of new to MeWe. It does cost to set up a page and maintain a page, but it's an actual congregating point rather than an individual feed. So that's one of the ways, since they don't force advertisements, that's one of the ways they monetize it slightly, is the people set up page and it costs money to set up a page and maintain a page. Not that much, but enough. And the cool part is, if you're looking at pages, these are things you wanted to see and you're going to see all of them. Unlike Facebook that filters them unless they boost, you'll actually see the pages that you follow and the recent posts from all the pages you follow in the order that they were posted right down the line. And if you don't like something, don't follow it. So once you do that, once you've got that established, those are the three kind of main feeds. Oh, sorry, the two I've discussed two of them. Let's talk about the third one, chats. Now, chats can be chats within a group, or chats with an individual, or chats with you specifically. So these chats are public chats for the groups or individual chats amongst the people. And it's kind of cool. You can get alerts on them and you can join in. These are, I'm going to call these fleeting moment type of interactions where, I mean, the chat goes really deep, it continues on. You just kind of jump into the most recent conversation. And this is stuff that's not necessarily post-worthy, let's say. It doesn't require a lot of thought. It's just people kind of having a conversation. And it can, again, it can be within a group. It can be on your on a, with an individual in a chat, or it can actually be on a part of a your chat, your actual page chats. So it's kind of cool. A couple of three ways to so it's a couple of three ways that you can actually interact with people directly. And like you said, so if you go to like mine on groups, I've got Biker Nerd group set up over there, just like have it. There's posts for within the group, and then there's a group chat down here in the corner, so people can actually have this running chat as well as the feed. Facebook's kind of done this lately. They've added a messenger function, kind of side chat thing. I think that was in response to MeWe, but it's there. So anyways, it's a little different. It's a lot sparser looking, which is actually kind of nice. And because you don't have a lot of the market stuff and the stuff that they're forcing down your throat, this is run by a libertarian. There are, of course, some community rules. It's not a completely open forum in that, if you start going on a racist rant and you become a real pain in the ass to everybody, eventually the system will get after you. So, I mean, have at. It's pretty much free speech. It's not arbitrary. It's not AI driven. It's a smaller community at this point in time, but it's also a much friendlier, in that it's friendlier to the free speech and the ability of you to express yourself and post what you want the way you want it. And the trolls have almost no power here, and they won't have. They will never have, which is why they will curse MeWe, and they will try to eventually create a situation where they declare it like Gab, that it's alt-right or some sort of background underground Illuminati driven thing. I mean, they will try to shut it down because they cannot stand having wrongthink out there, and wrongthink being anything that doesn't agree with them. So they just can't let people talk amongst themselves. They have to follow toe the line and speak the way that they want them to speak. So, but on this particular platform, those individuals have zero power. So anyways, that's why I'm over on MeWe now. I think a majority of my postings will be here on MeWe. They'll be driven into MeWe, and I may move them out into Twitter and Facebook on a kind of interim basis, but this is where I will eventually head. There's a few groups that have already left Facebook to head this way. I mean, entire groups. And again, it isn't anything specifically to any politics or anything like that. They're just tired of people out of nowhere, basement dwelling trolls, reporting. Eventually Facebook blocks them or suspends them, even though there was nothing really valid. The AI just takes over. And I don't care. If Facebook falls on its ass and goes broke, that's Facebook's fault. They could have done the same thing that MeWe did, which was basically, if you don't like something that someone says and you report them, then you automatically, you're forced to block them as well, and you can't communicate or look at anything else they say. There, done. If it was really bad, that group gets suspended, and otherwise you don't have to see anything they said. But the trolls and the panty twisters, they don't want that feature, because then they can't go tell everybody else how to think and how to speak and make sure that they're policing everybody else's thoughts and actions. Anyways, that is the end of my little diatribe. So that's MeWe in a nutshell. I kind of like it. It's a little different. Takes a little bit of getting used to, but it's kind of fun. And they do have a phone app that lets you interact the same way. I would immediately turn off the notifications that ding every time someone makes a chat comment, because that will ding you to death. There's a lot more activity over here than there used to be. All right. We will talk to you later.